Imagine AI that thinks faster, remembers more, and handles massive amounts of data in real time. That's what these state-space models, or SSMs, bring to the table. They let AI track hidden patterns over time, and they turn them into actionable insights. Now, when we combine this with cutting-edge architectures and optimized hardware, now these innovations, they're making AI a lot faster and much more efficient. SSMs, they are neural building blocks. They act as memory layers by learning how information evolves over time to make them powerful tools for processing sequential type data. Now, ultimately, what these SSMs are, they do three things. The first one is they remember what has happened, right, in the past. Now, the second part is they actually update the memory over time as these patterns change. And the third item is they make a prediction. And when you combine this together, this is what the SSM helps us to achieve here. Now, first, let's dive into SSMs and figure out what they really are. Now, these state-space models, they represent systems using two key components. Now, the first one is called the state equation. Now, this models how a hidden state evolves over time. And if we get down into it, the x sub t is a state vector at time t, while the matrix A defines how that system changes. Now, the u sub t, it's what we call the control or bias inputs, while B is the matrix that also changes how the inputs affect that state. Now, finally, the w, it processes this noise that can impact even creativity of the system. But in essence, this state equation, it says how the world evolves internally. But now let's link this to generative AI. So let's take text, for example. So we first create what's called an embedding. Now this embedding is an input into the model to update its hidden state or evolving memory. Now the optional input, u sub t, could be the prompt embedding. Then interestingly, this w sub t can be what's called that random variability that enables the model to be very creative. Now the second part of the equation, this is called the observation piece. Now this maps the hidden state to the observed output. And let's get into it just a little bit, and let's look at the y sub t. This is the observed output at time t, while the C matrix, it maps these hidden states to observations. Now the matrix D, it's fed through this system, and it affects and impacts the input to output, while the v sub t, it introduces this measurement error. Now this equation also says how the model sees the world. Now linking this to Gen AI, the y sub t is really that next token in that sequential data. And then from this state equation, the x sub t is used to determine what token to create next. While the v sub t, it'll give it that creativity that we might be looking for. Now the learned matrices C and D, they influence how the output text is then created. Now when we put both of these together, this enables us to model these systems with these hidden dynamics. Now these types of models were first used throughout the field of robotics. And if we take, for example, common filters, this helps robots to estimate its true position, even when there's readings that are very, very noisy. But now, if we look at today, these SSMs are being used within AI and machine learning. They've been adapted to handle the sequential data, such as speech, text, or any time series data. SSMs have become one of the most important mathematical frameworks in the evolution of generative AI. So, what's not really open for debate is that GPUs, they're expensive. We have to do this model training and inference. Both require a lot of these GPUs. And traditional transformers, they're just really inefficient during inference time. Now, the largest bottleneck, right, is GPU memory bandwidth, which is very prevalent for the transformer-based architecture. So, for example, an 8 billion model, it can barely fit onto an H100 GPU that has about 80 gigs worth of memory. Now the KV cache alone, it takes about 64 gigs in size, and add in another 8 gigs of the model weights, and we're about at 90% memory capacity, and then try to move that around. That's when we hit this bandwidth problem. Now the interesting part is that GPUs can only be at half util rate or at use, while maybe we're waiting for this data to be moved in and out of memory. Now this is that data movement problem. Now we can think of this as there could be a 15 times increase in compute capacity over time, right? But at the same time, there's a much smaller amount of improvement in this memory and bandwidth. It might just be a 3x. Now the tells when this is a problem is when the GPU use is really low, but the memory bandwidth is nearly full. Now, performance barely improves when we begin to add more cores. We can also try to increase the batch size, but this helps to only reuse, you know, the asset memory, and we still need to move in and out these bits and bytes. But this is where SSMs really can come into the picture to help us out. So first of all, we can use what are called these long sequences. Right? This is where we can use the SSMs to help us process the sequential data that comes in over time, like we mentioned, text, sound, or any other type, right? And then we also have these transformers, right? Whenever we want to compare them, right? And what's interesting is that transformers take big O to the N squared versus the SSMs take about O to the N and cost to model these types of long sequences here. Now let's take a look at, we have this implicit memory structure. So the SSMs, they don't store all the past tokens explicitly, but instead what they do is they will store them within those equations that we showed before, right? And then if we go off to the next one, this is where we have this continuous time element piece to it, right? And this is where we want to have the SSMs, they use this continuous signals to model these said sequences. And then the final part would be, what if we could combine many things together, right? So we might combine SSMs with the transformers. And this removes a lot of the bottlenecks in these neural network architectures, right, that we just said. But what we can do is we can think of it like this, is that AI transformers, they remember everything, whereas a state-space model remembers only what really matters. We've had several architectural breakthroughs. For example, the structured state-space sequence model, or S4, emerged. This is a new kind of neural network layer that's really designed to handle these long sequences of data. This helps us to get over that scaling wall that faced traditional transformers. It's really a very efficient memory system that can remember what happened a long time ago without having to look at everything. First, I would like to talk a bit about the key idea, which is to model the dynamics of memory with a state vector that's continually updated. So we can think of it like this. So a transformer, it remembers different things or everything that happens. Now this state space model, it remembers only what matters. Now if we go to speed, we can then look at this, that it's very slow and it takes a long time for the transformer to process all of what it remembers. Now, if you go to the S4, it's very fast and efficient with those two equations that I showed you before. So now we're at memory. A transformer memory, it grows very quickly with that exponential growth that it has to deal with. But then when we go to the S4, it's very compact, modeled again by those two different equations. Now, the fourth concept would be what it works like. So a transformer, what it has to do, it literally has to reread almost an entire book before answering. Now the S4, it can read only notes and then begin to answer the same question that the transformer would have had. Now, if we begin to look at the Mamba piece in this family tree, we then look at a model that's designed for this real world and large scale generative AI. So it builds upon the S4 by adding what's called selectivity. Now this enables the model to focus on what matters, similar to attention within a transformer, but it also retains those properties of being fast like the SSM. In fact, it is a type of an SSM. Now it is unstructured and it changes over time. Now what it also does is it introduces matrices that change dynamically depending upon the input so that the model can then selectively update its memory. This enables the model to ignore these unimportant tokens that really don't contribute to the answer. Now this is huge. This gives Mamba this attention-like flexibility without the cost of that full attention that a transformer would potentially have to run. Now the math, it's very much optimized for this hardware-friendly piece instead of having these very large matrices of multiplications that it has to use. We now in turn use convolutions and these simple multiplications. One example would be Mamba models, right? So they include the Mamba 1, which was released in 2024. Now this was the original model. And then we go down into these multimodal models like Mamba Byte, Vision Mamba, Audio Mamba, and those others that help us to understand the world around us and the way in which it's presented. Now we look at Mamba 2, which is more performant than the Mamba 1 model here. We could think of it this way, that S4 taught AI how to remember efficiently, while the Mamba family of models taught it how to remember intelligently. Now today, the mainstream LLMs such as Granite V4, it's built on a hybrid SSM as well as transformers that have further improvements with Mamba. You'll even see some hybrid SSMs on top of benchmark leaderboards. In fact, these are very small models that could be 1 billion to 350 million parameter sizes that could even run on your phone, laptops, maybe even a CPU and consumer grade GPUs. And check out this performance graph. I mean, it's really impressive when you see at the top, we have some of these hybrid type models now. And there we have it. We've seen how state-space models are quietly reshaping the future of AI. Faster thinking, smarter memory, and more efficient learning. They've evolved from elegant math into these engines behind next-generation models like S4 and Mamba, helping AI really focus on what truly matters. But together with these new architectures and hardware advances, they're breaking past limits and redefining what intelligent systems can do. The future of AI isn't just about bigger models, but it's about models that can remember better, think faster, and evolve continuously.